Hi everybody again, this is Ahmed Ibrahim from Papyrus Incorporated. I like to go through certain videos. I think it will be quite interesting. I have been receiving before and now some inquiries about the Papyrus Headbox relaxation tables. Of course, I mentioned that that's probably one of the core of the kind of technical service which Papyrus offer to the paper industry. It is the ultimate as far as process control in the head box is concerned. Of course, you know, I am using scientific equations based on high level research material, fundamental equations known to every engineer and scientist like yourself. I was able to put it together in a way that I can do the calculations quick, accurate, elaborate, and easy to understand. And I call it relaxation tables because the operator should relax. He doesn't have to go through the agony of the trial and error approach. And I like to just explain to you how the tables are, in brief, are constructed. And in summary, what you do, because I mentioned in earlier videos that the calculations by process control companies are fundamentally incorrect, and I'm responsible for that kind of statement. And because of that, once you do things right, you will see instant improvement. How far this deviation from the improvements is shown, you will see results. Some are big, or some are quite small, depending on the departure. So let me explain, just bear with me a little bit. Let me explain to you how they are constructed. Over here, this is depending on the kind of head box which you are dealing with. And I, you know, there is a family of head boxes, hydraulic, air padded, gap formers, suction formers, you name it. I choose over here rectifier roll type and hydraulic type. And the calculation, some there are similarity and some there are different. Of course, I make the tables from a minimum wire speed. This is a range of wire speed from a minimum, the way you are running up till the maximum, and sometimes even more than the maximum. You can see here the range in increments. Typically, I make it every 10 feet, but that number can be also changing every 3 feet, every 4 feet, every 5 feet, or meter feet per minute, or you know, whatever. Over here, this is the range of the slice opening. And when you say that slice opening, are you sure that the slice opening are really actual, the way it is absolute numbers? So these are correlation between the actual and whatever the DCS numbers are giving it to you, or the digital readout and that kind of things. So these measurements have to be done. Of course, beforehand, before I conducted the calculation, and that's your responsibility to supply me with this kind of information. Over here, you just bear with me a little bit, you don't have to go to more details. Again, the same in the apron extension. When I say, let us say 1 inch, is really 1 inch in the DCS. Maybe it reads 0.8. You know, that's the kind of things deceiving. So once I establish this correlation, statistically, I already know what they are and translate the DCS numbers to the absolute values. Over here, you know, of course, I said actual and the computer, whatever you have, you know, in the DCS or maybe scales, the definition which you run. I put the forming board here. I select the position of the forming board based on detailed analysis. And what I do, I maintain a constant angle at a given wire speed, at a given slice geometry, for a constant forming board position to get you there. These are complex calculations. And then I give you the right head. taking into consideration all these six or seven variables which I mentioned before, the kinetic energy, the velocity energy, pressure energy, potential energy, and you name it, the jet angle and so on. The relationship between the slice opening and the apron extension determine the angle, which I determine again in the analysis. You don't have to go through this calculation. I already, take care of this calculation. And then I give you the gallons per minute based on the slice opening, the actual. I give you the flow rate. Most of the time, the flow rate, either by, again, measurement, by the DCS, is not actually correct. There is what we call contraction coefficient of the jet, which changes based on the slice geometry, the design of the slice, the profile bar, and a whole bunch of equations. And then I give you the level of the head box. Again, I determine that. And for every given level, and I know the flow rate, then I give you the RPM, the revolution, the speed of the rolls. These are the optimum values which I determine that. I know the flow rate, I know the level, I know the width of the machine, then I calculate the velocity, I know the diameter, then I match the two together. And they are not constant. Every time you change the flow rate, I'm going down over here. You change the flow rate, you have to change the RPM, and so on. These are basically, what I'm talking about in the rectifier rolls. So what you do, you run the machine the way you run it, you set the head box by the controller the way you want it, and then you determine, you set that head, you work with the head, which I already calculated that. That gives you the ultimate as far as the sheet formation or strength development if you wanted to do that. Now you know your right and left. If you want to rush, then you increase the pressure head. If you want to drag, you reduce the pressure head in increments within boundaries depending on the speed. That's basically, in summary about the rectifier rolls. And then I'm going to go to the hydraulic head box. Of course, hydraulic head box, there is no rectifier rolls of anything of that nature, but basically this is the slice opening related, correlated to the DCS or the scales or whatever, or the digital readout. This is the apron extension, again correlated to that, and that's the head, and this is the flow rate. One thing you notice in hydraulic head boxes, the head is sensitive to the flow rate. Why? Because you typically run at high flow rate, and the depths where the pressure transmitted is, the pressure transmitter is located, is in a narrow area. Q equals V times A. The area is constant and very sensitive. Flow rate determines the velocity energy. You have to subtract it from the total head to get the pressure energy. You can see over here one head. When I increase the flow rate, different head. If you don't do that, you will be rushing that head by the amount of that energy. So in summary, same wire speed, different flow rates, different heads, and the DCS doesn't pick up that. Then you will be deceived. You don't know really what your right and what is your left. That's, very important. Again, the forming board, as I mentioned before, I determine that and make, the proper recommendation according to, whatever conditions you do have. One thing I want to mention before I forget, I calculate a number here. I call it pound per square inch, or weight per unit area, or kilogram per square meter. You can take that number if you know which block you are, either one of the head boxes. Then you can determine material balance, fibers alone, fillers alone, or total solids without taking samples from the white water tank, or vice versa. It's a very neat calculations, and you can take advantage of that kind of things. And after that, I'm going to go through some interesting abstracts, quotations, and just my mind to explain to you what I believe going on in that head box area. Just bear with me in the following videos. Hopefully that you can enjoy it. And I can summarize also some of my my feelings and my conclusion, what is going on in that area.